Singapore discusses cross-border blockchain payments, and we have a date for Ethereum to move from their proof-of-work to their proof-of-stake network. Let's start the show. Welcome back to Crypto Global News. Thanks for tuning into today's show. I'm Edward, and we really appreciate it if you like, share, and also subscribe. Enjoy today's episode. Sopnendu Mohanty, the chief fintech officer of the Monetary Authority of Singapore, said that blockchain has potential for cross-border payments, but the agency does not see much in retail bank digital currencies. The Monetary Authority of Singapore has learned a variety of blockchain-related use cases, including how to deploy the technology to organize payments in the banking system, settle payments against securities, as well as how to conduct cross-border payments. Now, will cross-border payments done using blockchain be used in many other countries across the globe? Changes made to the public application programming interface, which is more commonly known as an API, of the major cryptocurrency exchange Binance, seemingly revealed that the company has enabled margin trading for 9 trading pairs. The pairs that have been enabled are the following: Bitcoin to Tether, Binance to Bitcoin, Binance to Tether, Ethereum to Bitcoin, Ethereum to Tether, Tron to Bitcoin, Tron to Tether, Ripple to Bitcoin, and Ripple to Tether. Binance first promised in the feature rollout section of its white paper that margin trading would be implemented after spot trading and before futures on its exchange. Binance continues to make bold moves in the cryptocurrency space. Will this latest play further grow their platform? Bitcoin is pushing its way close to $6,000, and the uptrend pushed Bitcoin's year-to-date rally to an impressive 54%. At the same time, it brought the asset's total recovery to an astounding 82% and set the cryptocurrency well on its way to a fresh record high. Now, factor trading author Peter Brandt suggested that the Bitcoin price could hit $19,800 in the future. He backed his prediction using a moving average indicator. Robert Slumer, a technical strategist at Wall Street strategy firm Fundstrat, also believes that Bitcoin is pounding into a bull market. The financial expert said the asset could initially go through a pullback toward its 200 weekly moving average following the most recent push towards 6,000. But after that, it could enter a mammoth accumulation phase, which, as reported by Fundstrat, the co-founder Thomas Lee, could push the price forward to 20,000. Now, if this does happen, how will this affect cryptocurrency? How will it affect the world of ICOs, IEOs, and commodities more generally? The Nasdaq has shown a growing affinity for Bitcoin. Now, the relationship has just gone to a higher level with the knowledge that CNBC's Africa crypto trader is going to start to broadcast from the Nasdaq studio. Rand Nooner, the host of the show, tweeted that the next season will launch from Times Square on the 9th of May 2019. The Nasdaq studio is in the middle of all the action, and it could be visible to tons of people passing by on their way to and from work, not to mention the many tourists that visit New York each year. It thrusts cryptocurrency into the heart of Manhattan, which will draw eyes and interest from all over the globe. Is this the time where institutional money takes over cryptocurrency and it really goes mainstream? A code for the Ethereum blockchain's first stage transition to a proof-of-stake consensus algorithm could be completed by the 30th of June 2019. Ethereum researcher Justin Drake claimed that the developer's team expects to prepare code specifications for phase zero by the end of June. Drake stated, "We are still very much on track. Still, code simplifications are coming through, which is great, and the process of fine combining is also finding these final bugs." With a move from proof-of-work to proof-of-stake, how will this affect Ethereum, and how will this affect the crypto marketplace moving forward? Many thanks for tuning into today's episode. Please make sure you like, share, and also subscribe to the show. For Crypto Global News, I'm Edward. Until next time, you take it easy.